I am from Gopras Math Shop. I am going to discuss question number 8, Roman 1, exercise 4.2. That has been taken from chapter 4, Determinant and NCERT 12 Mathematics. Question number 8, Roman 1, exercise 4.2 is, prove that date elements of a row 1, A square. The elements of second row 1, B, B square. The elements of third row 1, C, C square. Here I shall write solution. Solution is equal to imply that LHS is equal to date elements of first row 1 A square. The elements of second row 1 B B square. The elements of third row 1 C C square. Here you can see the elements of first row 1 A square. The elements of second row 1 B B square. The elements of third row 1 C C square. Here I shall write imply that LHS is equal to these LHS. Here I shall use property. Here in RHS you can see A minus B is there and B minus C and C minus A is there. So here I shall use the property in this determinant, so I have to get A minus B. So if I do, this is R1 minus R2, I can easily get A minus B here. So here I shall write by using the property, R1 goes to R1 minus R2. R1 goes to R1 minus R2. By using the property, R1 goes to R1 minus R2. So here, the determinant will become LHS equal to, here it says R1 goes to, this means that changes will occur only in first row. There will be no changes in second row and third row. Here, I shall write second row and third row as it is. Here R1 goes to, this means that only changes will occur in first row. There will be no changes in second row and third row. That's why second row and third row I have written as it is. Changes will occur only in first row. So here I shall write R1 goes to R1 minus R2. R1 goes to, if I take the element of R1 here 1, so here write 1, minus there, right here minus, the corresponding element of 1 in the second row will be 1, so here write 1, comes out to here 0, so here I shall write 0. Again, R1 goes to, if I take the element of R1 as A, so here write A, minus the corresponding element of A in the second row will be B. So here write B. R1 goes to A minus B, it will come. So here you will get A minus B. So here I shall write second element of first row A minus B, and again R1 goes to, if I take the element of R1 as A square, so here write A square, minus is there, right here minus, the corresponding element of A square in the second row will be B square. here write b square. So you will get here a square minus b square. This thing you will get here. Just b square c square, write just below a square minus b square. This thing will get. What we'll do here? Again, I shall use the property. Here you can see, in the second row, elements are 1b, b square. In third row, elements are 1c, c square. So here, easily, from the first row, I can get a minus b. So here you will get a minus b. But here b minus c is there. So I shall use a property such that I can easily here get b minus c. If I use the property by using the property R2 goes to R2 minus R3. This property I shall use. R2 goes to R2 minus R3. The I shall get here LHS equal to the elements of first row will be written as it is, because here it says R2 goes to. This means that changes will only occur in the second row. There will be no changes in first row and third row. The first row will be written as it is. So here write 0. Here write A minus B. Here write A minus B in one bracket, and another write here A plus B. Leave some space here. Here write A minus B. Here write in bracket A minus B, A plus B. And here I shall use the property. Here it says R2 goes to. This means that changes will only occur in second row. There will be no changes in first row and third row. The first row and third row will be written as it is. So here I am going to write the third row 1c, c square I have written. Only changes will occur in second row. The second row here I shall write R2 goes to R2 minus R3. If I take the element of R2 as 1, so here write R2 goes to 1 minus the corresponding element of 1 in the third row will be 1. So here write 1, comes out to 0. So here I shall write 0. Here write I shall 0. And again R2 goes to R2. If I shall take the element of R2 as B, so here write B. This minus will be reflected here. And the corresponding element of B in the third row will be C. So here write C. So here you will get B minus C. So here I shall write B minus C. And again R2 goes to R2 goes to, if I take the element of R2 as b square, so here write b square, minus is there, right here minus, and the corresponding element of b square in the third row will be c square, so here write b square minus c square, so here write b square minus c square, this thing will get. This is the rough work. I can enclose this rough work in the box here. This thing you have got 0, b minus c, b square minus c square. Here you have got 0, a minus b, this one you have got, this one. Again, what you do here? Here you can get LHS equal to, here you can see in the first row elements are 0, A minus B, A minus B dot A plus B. So here from the first row we can take easily common as A minus B. So here I shall take common A minus B. So here take common A minus B. And also in the second row you can see here 0 B minus C B square minus C square. Just I am going to write this data as it is. So here write 0. Since I have taken A minus B as a common from the first row, the first row it will comes out to here 1, and here you will get A minus B has been taken as a common here. So you will get here A plus B. And this second row I can write very well 0 B minus C and B square minus C square. B square minus C square can be written as B minus C and B plus C. B minus C, B square minus C square can be written as B minus C, B plus C. And third row will be written as it is. Right here that. This comes out to here again in the second row you can see 0 B minus C, B minus C dot B, B plus C. So in the second row also you can take easily common as B minus C. So from the second row, if I take here LHS, I shall write here LHS equal to A minus B. I have written here A minus B. Now take common B minus C from the second row. We will get here. You will get here 0, 1, A plus B you will get. Take common B minus C from the second row. Here you will get here 0, 1, B plus C. And in the third row, I shall write it is 1 C, C square. This thing will get. Here in the debt, here in the debt, you can see here, in the first column, there are two elements which are 0 here. This one, 0 here. So here I shall expand this determinant along first column. So here I shall write by expanding determinant along C1. By expanding determinant along C1, you will get LHS. LHS will get, here I shall write LHS. Just I have drawn here vertical line here. Here write LHS. LHS equal to, by expanding determinant along C1, so LHS you will get here A minus B, B minus C, dot. And open here, curly bracket here. Along C1 means first column. Along C1 means first column. This date is going to be expanded along first column. So here write plus 1. So here write plus 1 will be written in bracket, and this 0 will become. The whole thing comes out to be, if you get the minor of 0 here, the whole thing comes out to here. Here you will get here easily 0. And here I shall write here minus 1. So this 0 will be reflected here, it comes out to 0 here. But here I shall write plus 1. So here I shall get plus 1. So this one will get, so I shall get here minor r plus 1. Minor r, this plus 1 will be, plus 1 will be the minor of 1 will be, since this one is there in first column and third row. The first column and third row will be hidden like this. The, you will get the easily the minor of plus 1. You will get the minor of plus 1 as 1 a plus b. The here I 1 a plus b. And here write 1 b plus c. So here I shall write LHS is equal to a minus b, b minus c dot. And again we will write here, open here curly bracket. This term plus 1 will multiply to 0, will here come out to 0. And here minus 1 will multiply to 0, comes out to here 0. And here I plus 1, in bracket I shall write, the elements of principal diagonal are 1 and b plus c. 1 will multiply to b plus c, here will get b plus c. Right here minus, the elements of reverse diagonal are 1 and a plus b. 1 and a plus b, which are the element of reverse diagonal, will multiply together. We'll get here a plus b. So here write a, and here write minus b. LHS you will get here very well. A minus b in one bracket, b minus c in second bracket, and here you will get in curly bracket. This will comes out to 0. And here at b plus c minus a minus b. So here plus b minus b will be cancelled out. Here we will get LHS. Usually LHS equal to a minus b, b minus c dot. Here C minus A is A is there. Here write C minus A. So LHS I have got here A minus B, B minus C, C minus A. Just compare LHS, this LHS with RHS. So here you can see A minus B, A minus B, B minus C, B minus C, C minus A, C minus A. So here I can write, hence LHS equal to RHS. This thing you have to prove here. So here, by going through all these processes and applying the properties of determinant here, I have proved this debt equal to A minus B, B minus C dot A minus C minus A. LHS equal to RHS is proved with the proper explanation by using appropriate properties in the determinant here. This is the complete explanation and solution of question number 8, Roman 1, exercise 4.2, chapter 4, determinant, NCERT 12 mathematics.